Thank you. The Denver Pioneers are in action tonight, Thursday night in the Mile High City. Their opponent, South Dakota, the Coyotes, come in 13-2 on the season. The Pioneers 8-7. Welcome inside Hamilton Gymnasium alongside Adam Gleason. I'm Brad Thompson. Thanks for joining us here tonight. We've got a good one. South Dakota undefeated in the Summit League a season ago. They may be better than that this year, and the Pioneers playing extremely well at home, and they're one of those teams coming up trying to chase the Coyotes right now and overtake them. So this is a great opportunity for the Pioneers.
Yeah, absolutely. The Pioneers, they want to compete for Summit League championships. If you're going to do that, you have to go through a perennial power like South Dakota, and nowhere better to do it than Hamilton Gymnasium.
The Pioneers, their strength is offensively, scoring the basketball, 83 points a game. On the flip side, South Dakota, they're very good defensively, so this is strength on strength in this matchup.
Yeah, the Pioneers, number one offensive team in the Summit League. The Coyotes, number one defensive team in the Summit League, and the Coyotes pride themselves on their defense. It'll be tough to score baskets, but if anyone's going to compete against them on the offensive end, it's going to be the Pioneers. It should be a fun game.
Pioneers have a number of sharpshooters, including Lauren Lovin, but one of the players to watch tonight, Madison Nelson, she's playing the best basketball of her career.
Yeah, 7 double-doubles already this season. She's scoring 15.3 points per game, which is fourth in the Summit League. She is going to have to play well tonight if they expect to win.
On the flip side for South Dakota, the players to watch, Allison Arnes and Kira Duffy, familiar names if you know the Pioneers and the Coyotes. They've been doing it for a long time. They're very good.
Yeah, very good guards. They both have experience. Arnes already has 1,000 points in her career, and Duffy is 34 points away. But scoring isn't all they do. They play well on the defensive end, and more importantly, they're great leaders.
Two players to watch indeed for the Coyotes. Now, Pioneers are led by head coach Jim Turgeon, and I sat down to ask him about this matchup. Here's what he had to say. Extremely well. What do the Pioneers have to do to be effective against this team and pick up the victory?
Well, they're very good. Their RPI net right now is 15th in the country. You know, they've played some high major teams and beat some and competed well with others. It's no secret. We got to defend a little bit better. A lot better. And what makes them tough to guard is they can do so many things. Every single one of their players can shoot a three, and every single one of them can drive the ball. So they're a very, very tough matchup. And then offensively, you know, they're the number one team defensive field goal percentage-wise in the conference, and they hold teams down in points. So, you know, that's what we do good is offense. But so offensively, if we don't have ball movement and people movement, we're going to struggle. And so I'm excited. I'm excited to see how our team does against this defense, actually.
South Dakota State has been one of the other teams at the top of the Summit League. But is this the measuring stick here when you look at the Summit League and who the Pioneers have to overcome to get to the place that you want them to be?
Yeah, you know, South Dakota went undefeated last year in the conference, which was just amazing. And I thought they might slip a little bit this year, and I think they're better. And I picked South Dakota State to win it, and South Dakota second. I hope they didn't hear that here before the game. But this team is very, very good. I think right now they're the best team in the conference. And, we'll see exactly where we're at. You know, we're talking about doing some special things this year and maybe trying to sneak in that NCAA tournament. So we're going to have to beat a team like this to do that.
Is that the motivation for the Pioneers? How have you handled that in the locker room, talking to this team and this group, saying hey, what an opportunity it is to knock off a team like South Dakota? And this is our home court. We got to defend it. If we want to get to those goals, we've got to win tonight.
Absolutely. And, you know, again, our non-conference schedule was probably a little tougher than it needed to be in our second year, and then all the road games. But even though we're playing at home, that kind of helped prepare us even for just because it's this quality of team. So, we've played – every game this year we've played really well at home except for one, and that was our last game at home. So I think our girls are excited to try to bounce back and show our fans that we're still a pretty dang good team.
You mentioned how versatile they are. They're very good defensively. With the Pioneers, their strength is the offensive end, shooting the basketball, ranked, you know, in the top in the country in a number of categories. Lauren Lovin leading the way from the outside. How do you get the players going from the outside? Is it simply the fact of making shots, or how do you work against their strong defense? But this is strength of the Pioneers, scoring the basketball.
Yeah, what I'm worried about against this team is their length. They have some shorter girls play, but overall their length is good at every position. So, you know, Lauren's only 5'7" or whatever she is, so getting those shots off. They're just so mentally and physically tough defensively. That's what I just said a little bit earlier. We have to have people, a lot of people movement, and and a lot of ball movement because they don't break down very often. So if we just stand around, it's going to be really hard to score. But, again, I'm excited to see how we do against them because this will be the best defensive team we've played by far.
You're excited. I'm excited. Coach, thanks for your time. Good luck. We've got a top matchup here in the Summit League. South Dakota here taking on the Denver Pioneers. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back with the starting lineups. You're watching Pioneer Basketball on Pioneer All Access. The Coyotes and the Pioneers getting set for a tip-off here from Hamilton Gymnasium. Pleasure to have you with us alongside Adam Gleason. I'm Brad Thompson. The Coyotes 13-2 on the season, regular season champs in the Summit League a year ago, 1-0 in Summit League play. The Pioneers 8-7, 6-1 here at home, 1-1 in conference play, both of those on the road. The starters for the Pioneers, number 12, sophomore guard, Claire Gritt. Number 22, senior guard, Sam Romanowski. Junior guard, number 3, Lauren Lovin. Number 23, the junior forward, Madison Nelson. And number 15, the senior center, Courtney Smith. Out there for the Pioneers. Number 10, Allison Arns. Number 24, Kira Duffy. Number 23, Madison McKeever. 22, Chloe Lamb. 15, Taylor Frederick are the starters for South Dakota. Adam, we've got a fantastic game. This is a measuring stick, really, for the Pioneers as that one goes up and in. Nice move from Frederick there on the low block. She's able to put it up and in for two.
Yeah, absolutely a measuring stick, and the Pioneers will have their hands full tonight, but should be a great opportunity to see how good they really are.
That pass trying to go over the top to Courtney Smith, and that was a mismatch. She was lined up there with Allison Arns, 5'10" senior guard, one of the best players in the conference, but she's defending on the low post against 6'2" Courtney Smith. Pass was just a little too much there.
Yeah, and South Dakota is so good at playing. They have so much length. They can play their guards down in the post. They play a lot of times with four guards.
Arns able to get inside. She's in the scoring column for the first time. She averages 9 points a game, 5 rebounds, over 2 assists. First team All-Summit League performer a season ago. She's on the preseason All-Summit League team. And a great lineage, family lineage at South Dakota with the Arms as Claire Gritt able to put that one up and in, the sophomore from Arlington Heights.
Yeah, great move by Gritt there just to get to the basket and respond to those quick 4 points from South Dakota to start the game.
Pioneers average 83 points a game. That's 15th best in the country. Tops in the Summit League as Duffy that time came up short. Fight for the rebound. Madison Nelson has it, the leading rebounder for the Pioneers. They give up only 55 points, or allow, I should say, 55 points per game. The Pioneers average 83. That's a big difference there. Something's got to give.
Yeah, and here on the defensive end, you see where South Dakota excels. They get a steal there. They're so good down on the defensive end. We'll see how things go.
Pioneers did not match up that time. As Lamb able to put that one up and in for two. She was left alone underneath. And 10 steals a game as a team. Mm-hmm. For the Coyotes, and they came up with one last time. Now an effort here from Grit. She lost her balance. Traveling is going to be the call, and there's a turnover for DU, something they've got to avoid. South Dakota takes it away so well. They can't have those unforced errors and the turnovers on their own, playing against a team with this kind of firepower and so good defensively.
Yeah, they're really going to have to start taking care of the ball better.
Arnes able to draw the contact there. Foul's going to go against Grit. Grit averaging 12.5 points, 5 rebounds, 2.3 assists. She can do it all. Very versatile guard, can score, plays great defense. And there's a reach in there. Kira Duffy is going to go to the free throw line. Nelson's going to pick up the foul. The junior 6'1" forward from Dover, Minnesota.
Duffy hits the first, but Brad, what you see there is South Dakota plays such great team basketball. If you're a fan of basketball, you'll like watching the South Dakota team and watching the Pioneers for that matter. Both play team basketball. Anyone can score on the floor at any time.
Especially if you've been following the Pioneers, you've seen the way they play offensively this year, the way they've shared the ball since Coach Turgeon has gotten here, and that's the way he wants to play. As Romanowski comes up a little short there, South Dakota plays that way offensively, but they also play that way defensively. They're very connected defensively as well, as Lamb knocks down the three, and she's got 5 already. It's 11-2, a great start as the Pioneers need to get on the board. That one deflected out. It should be Pioneer basketball. It remains DU basketball. Jasmine Jeffcoat, 6'2", sophomore forward from Louisville, Colorado, is in. Number 33, Grace White, number 1, also in, the sophomore, 5'10", from Redby, Minnesota, and the Pioneers give it back.
Yeah, I mean, again, they're down by 9 already in the first 3 minutes of this game. That's not something you can do against a great defensive team. It's a lot harder to come back against a team like South Dakota.
Duffy inside, spinning. That one's going to come off the rim. She's able to get her own rebound, kicks it out, but Romanowski there for the steal. Now to Lauren Lovin, leading scorer for the Pioneers. One of the best shooters in all the land here. Pull-up jumper on the way. Great sign for Lovin. That first one goes down. She's got 60 made three-pointers on the season.
Yeah, an incredible number.
Leading the country.
They just started the conference, but always like to see a shooter get their first basket to go in. That's a good sign.
That's going to be a jump ball. Pioneers are going to have it back. Simba Malonga back in there. 5'8", freshman guard from Bolingbrook, Illinois. Jeffcoat gets a breather. Grit getting a breather. Nelson also back on the floor.
And you see a lot of subs early for Denver. They're really trying to conserve energy here. Lately, in the last few games, they've struggled in the fourth quarter. Maybe trying a new strategy here, giving their subs some minutes early.
Pioneers without Sydney Mack. They have been for a number of games. She's out with an injury. They miss her dearly. She's a very talented freshman, great size, great length, versatile, and especially against an opponent like South Dakota, her length and athletic ability is a huge miss when she's not out there.
Yeah, absolutely. They're 1-5 without Sydney Meck. Now down on the other end, we saw a great job by DU to use that whole shot clock, get a great job, a basket for Nelson to cut this lead down to 5.
Pioneers climbing back in it. Jeffcoat coming back in. White's gonna sit down. Last game for the Pioneers. They've only played 2 league games, right? So they're at Western Illinois in Macomb, 28-9.
Yeah.
Bad start for the Pioneers. They eventually battled back. A lot of heart, a lot of grit. They got back into it. But it's good to see the Pioneers here. They've got 4 points in a row. Mm-hmm. They cannot fall into that same trap.
No.
As getting down early against a team like this. It'll be hard. Western Illinois is a good team. It'll be harder to come back against a defense like
Absolutely.
This.
They were down by 22 at one point in the first half there against Western Illinois. They fought back and took the lead in the third quarter and couldn't finish it out. But against a team like South Dakota, you're not even going to get close to coming back if you get down by that many points.
Pioneers trying to come up with a stop here. Courtney Smith, 15, coming back in, the senior transfer from Northern Colorado. Thornton, Colorado native. A couple of subs in for the Coyotes. Monica Arnes, younger sister of Allison. As Allison goes up with a left hand and she scores. 34, Hannah Shervin, also in their center for South Dakota. And that one off the leg of Malanga. And another turnover for the Pioneers. 13-6 is the advantage right now for the visitors.
Yeah, already 4 turnovers in the first 4 minutes of this game. And that's something that's going to have to turn around for the Pioneers if they want to stay in this game with South Dakota. South Dakota being very efficient on the offensive end and playing very well on the defensive end. You can see why they've beat 2 AP-ranked teams already this season.
Number of big wins on the schedule already for South Dakota. Now, Allison Arnes has subbed out along with Duffy, and Nelson coming away with a steal, racing the other way up with a left hand, and it's in.
Nelson, you mentioned it early on, playing the best basketball of her career. She was right in the right position there, and we need her to play well if we're going to have a chance.
We've talked a lot about how versatile these guards are, some of the forwards are for South Dakota. Mm-hmm. Nelson is very versatile with her size and her ability. 6'1", she's extremely athletic. She's averaging over 15 points, 9.5 rebounds, and you mentioned in the open, she also leads the team in blocks and steals. And here's another example of it.
Yeah, right here, just right place at the right time. Great job, great hands. Finishes out at the end of, finishes it on the other end.
Grit's going to be whistled for a foul. That's going to be number 2 for Claire Grit. That's going to be a tough one. And they need her out there, certainly.
And that's something that she's struggled with a little bit. In their last home game, she fouled out, which ended up costing the Pioneers possibly the win there. And she plays aggressively, which is great, but she has to play a little bit more under control, especially with the injuries the Pioneers are facing right now with Meck, Curtin, and Johnson all out on the bench.
5:03 to go, first quarter. Grit has subbed out there with those 2 personal fouls. Lauren Lovin back in there. But we'll keep an eye on what Coach Turgeon does and how many minutes she gets here before halftime. We're just halfway through the first quarter, so hopefully she'll be back out there. And she's a very smart player, so you know Coach can trust her being out there to handle those minutes. But you never know when a call goes the wrong way, as Nelson got bumped there, eventually gets knocked to the floor. Liv Corn Gable, number 2, is out there along with number 1, Claudia Kunzer, out there as well. South Dakota, very deep team. They sub a lot. They've got a number of players that are very similar in their skill set, so they can rotate a lot of players out. They can play a lot of different positions. They start out with a 4-guard lineup to start the game. They've got good size at guard, so that allows them to play that way. But it's an impressive team. The Pioneers looking to get back on track, really. Mm-hmm. They've had a tough road stretch. Has to do with, you know, in talking to Coach, a lot of it has to do with that break. So academically, in school now, they're off from Thanksgiving through the new year.
Yeah.
So they do a lot of traveling then. They don't have to miss any school. So that's a benefit of it. Unfortunately, then you've got a lot of road games in a row, and the schedule kind of flips for you. You start with a bunch of home games, then you're on the road, and it can be tough.
Yeah, I think it was tough for a lot of reasons, right? You go from all the home games to road games, which is obviously a whole nother ball game going into somebody else's arena. But we mentioned it. Sydney Meck got hurt in that game against Southern Utah, and since then they've been 1-5. And Sydney Meck, you know, she's not everything for this team, but she did so much. She's so versatile. And it lowered the depth of the bench, right? So in this game, we see it particularly, you mentioned it with South Dakota, they have so much depth and they have so many people that they can rotate in, play the same position. Denver, on the other hand, their starting 5 are all playing more than 26 minutes a game. I mean, they're relying heavily on those 5 players at this point. So it's kind of the tale of 2 different styles of team here.
Yeah, and it's tough when you look over there. We mentioned every game, Bree Johnson.
Yeah.
Went out right before the season. She's out for the entire year. So that's one starter. She's a point guard. So that's the last person you want to lose as far as your floor general and your leader right before the season. Now Sydney Mack, very talented freshman, is out. So they're playing without two starters right now. And when you're looking at that depth, certainly a healthy team like South Dakota is going to have a lot more of it. Haley Simmental, number 10, into the contest for the Pioneers. 5'8 senior guard from Pueblo West, Colorado. Simmental, Nelson, Romanowski, Lovin, and Smith out there for DU. 15-8 is the score here in the first quarter. Nelson up and under move with a one-handed scoop shot.
And that is a shot that last year, if you watched this team, Nelson would have never made that shot. She would have probably traveled on that play. She's grown so much as a player.
Shervin underneath, good defense there by Smith to hold her ground, not bite on that initial fake. And getting back to Nelson as Lovin's going to fire three. That one came up short. Nelson 3 for 3, 6 points. So she's right there. I mean, she's 0.2 of a point behind Lovin. So they're both at 15, over 15 points a game. 7 double-doubles for Nelson. It's now Lovin's heading the other way. That layup came off. Surprising there. Smith trying to come up with a steal. It's down on the ground. That could have been a double dribble call.
That's what I thought.
They are saying it got stripped away, so she had it knocked away and then regained possession. But three on the way here for Corn Gable, and she knocks it in.
Well, that was a big sequence of events right there. Missed layup leads to a three on the other end, a five-point swing, and all of a sudden Denver's down 10 again.
Nelson in the corner right in front of the Coyotes bench. Jab step. Now she fires off the mark.
That hesitation can really cause a shot to be flat, just like you saw right there.
And this is a time where you hope to make up some ground if you're the Pioneers. Mm-hmm. Allison Arns is on the bench. Kira Duffy is on the bench. It's two of their top players, and you hope to make up some ground when they go to that second team. And it has not been the case so far.
Yeah, and we'll see right here, Smith just reaching over there, and she's the one player on South Dakota that can outsize Smith there, and you're absolutely right. This is the chance Denver needs to take to gain some ground back, but this is where having grit on the bench really hurts you as well.
Jeffcoat coming in for Smith. Duffy, Allison Arns, McKeever, and Lamb all check back in. Shervin is at the line. She's a new player to this team, transferred in from New Mexico. So she was with the team last year. She's originally from Rogers, Minnesota, 6'2", redshirt sophomore, leads the team in rebounds, steals, blocks, and field goal percentage. So she's one to watch. She comes off the bench, and she's going to pick up the foul here. Anna Shervin, the guilty party. Well, Jeffcoat, who just checked in, picking up the foul.
And South Dakota on an 8-0 run in the last minute to push this lead out to 13. It was down to 5, and all of a sudden, now you're in a pretty deep hole.
Shervin with 2 fouls has to check out. Simmental has the inbounds, top of the key. Lovin with an opening on the way, off the mark. Frederick up high for the rebound. She's going to run the break here. Hesitation dribble, now spinning in the lane, up with it. What a play. Well, Taylor Frederick, 6-foot junior, just wheeling and dealing right from the defensive glass.
And you talk about that being your forward, your post player. And that's just the versatility that South Dakota has.
Lovin answering with a 3. She now has 5 in the contest. Not shy after missing the 3 on the last possession. And she's got no conscience. She makes so many. She makes it look so easy. 50% from beyond the arc coming into the game for Lauren Lovin. Tops in the country. Oh, we got a block here by Jeffcoat. Coming over to help Lovin defensively. She sent that one back.
Denver leads the Summit League in blocks as well, 5.9 per game.
When you look at the statistics, there's almost all of the statistics, whether it's offensively or defensively, these two teams are tops in the Summit League when you go down the list.
Absolutely. They're all on all the offensive side of statistics in the Summit League. These teams are all in all categories fourth or better. They're the top of the league here on offense. And, of course, South Dakota comes in. The one area where Denver struggles is points per game
allowed.
And they're actually eighth out of nine, I think, in the Summit League now.
Because we have North Dakota
coming in. So, yeah, so just two top teams here, and Denver's just really struggling down 12.
McKeever, nice pass inside, and traveling is going to be called there. Frederick, the guilty party in the lane. McKeever with a nice pass underneath. Yeah. The defense really collapsed around Frederick there, so traveling is going to be the call. Romanowski, we haven't heard much from her yet. Very good distributing the basketball. She's moved over to that point guard position without Johnson out in there as Jeffcoat, a bucket, and she's going to go to the line.
Well, a great pass. Jeffcoat had a great position in the lane. It started with that. You just mentioned it. Romanowski has a knack for finding the open player, giving them the ball where they need it. Right here, we'll see Jeffcoat finishing through contact, something that she's been working on since she got to DU. So nice to see her finish the three-point play here.
Jeffcoat converts. Romanowski, 5.9 assists per game. That's 21st best in the country. And picking up the assist there. Now the kick out to Lamb. She's hit 1-3 already. This one is online and in.
Well, and what you see there is just team basketball. Driving the lane, collapsing the defense, kicking out for an open three.
Back at the other end, Malonga dropping that bucket in. Pioneers starting to find some of their offensive firepower, the stroke offensively. They've got to defend. Duffy inside. She came up short. She had a good look. Pioneers clear the glass. Now up ahead. Malonga just going a little bit too fast, it seems like, right now. Dribble one off her leg earlier. Just trying to do a little bit too much. A freshman knowing playing against one of the big teams in the league. But a beautiful pass there from Simba to Sam Romanowski.
Well, that was a little bit of a taste of their own medicine for South Dakota. A backdoor cut. Smart basketball. And Duffy's not going to miss one like she did down here very often. So Denver taking advantage of that, cut the lead to 8 here, and South Dakota will take the last shot of the quarter.
Pioneers hoping for a stop, keeping it single digits here. McKeever inside trying to draw contact. Now the Pioneers have a chance. Nelson running, shot, and are they going to call a foul? Traveling is going to be the call. I was like, that should be generous. Foul call for the Pioneers, but
that
traveling.
Been nice. That would have been
that's
nice.
That's a tricky situation. Nelson's going full speed. Probably didn't have a chance to look at the clock as Arns is going to miss here from half court. 28-20 is the score after the first quarter from Denver. South Dakota with the lead. They got out early, 11-2. Pioneers hanging with them since then. See if the offensive firepower gets going in the second quarter for the Pioneers. Stay with us. More basketball to come here on Pioneer All Access. Both teams back out on the floors for the start of the second quarter. South Dakota 28, Denver 20. Early on in Summit League play. Pioneers, this is their third Summit League game, 16th game overall. 16th game overall as well for South Dakota, but just their second Summit League game. Their first week they had a bye at one game, but did not have two like the Pioneers did. That's a tie-up possession arrow favoring DU, and You got to love that if you're Coach Turgeon.
Yeah.
The message, I'm sure, had a lot to do with defense during that quarter break, and right away you forced a turnover.
Yeah, and really there, the one thing that might not be as positive was Malanga giving up the offensive rebound to Arns there, but great hustle from Jeffcoat to tie it up.
Both teams shooting the ball well. 55% for South Dakota, 60% for DU. That one deflected. South Dakota able to get it back. McKeever with the shot clock running down. Lamb has been hot. She's hit two from outside already. This one hit the bottom of the rim, but Arns the first one to get there, and she puts it back in.
Yeah, and Arns, her experience, she's just working Malanga on that offensive end, going around for the offensive rebound there. It's frustrating, but Malanga hopefully will learn as she goes here.
Well, that's certainly a matchup that favors South Dakota, the senior on a freshman of the Pioneers, and not just a senior, 1,000-point score, does all the little things, but Nelson banking one in. Thursday night and the bank is open.
When things are going right, sometimes it all goes right. So great, great bucket for Nelson there, much needed.
Malanga here guarding Allison Arns. Thought about the three, now into the lane, kick out to her sister Monica, and she knocks it down.
Again, it's that inside-out basketball. They just play team basketball. They collapse the defense, kick it out for an open shot, or get the layup on the drive.
How many times did that happen during their youth or in their driveway? As Lauren Lovin burying a three, her second of the game. Watch out for Lauren Lovin to get hot here. She heats up quickly, and the Pioneers need some scoring right now. Romanowski coming up with a deflection, but McKeever got it back. Now Jeffcoat with the steal. She's going down by herself to put it in for two.
Nice job defensively there. Just great awareness from Jeffcoat to jump the pass. She's having a great night so far. It's good to see her play well.
Smith has been on the bench. Jeffcoat getting a lot of minutes here and taking advantage. Monica Arns with a shot fake from the outside, blocked by Lovin. Now Nelson got a piece of that one. Pass goes all the way across to Lamb, who's left wide open. And the shooter's touch there from Chloe Lamb. My goodness.
Well, just a scramble mode there. The ball bounced three times across the lane to get to that wide open shooter.
Along the baseline, Romanowski three on the way. It's good.
Well, there's no place like home, Brad, and the Pioneers are feeling good, shooting 68% right now from the field.
Arns from way outside, but she connects.
You talk about a competitor, Arns. We talked about it before the game. Grit just reminds us a lot of Arns. They're both competitors. They hit big shots. They want the ball in big moments, and she hit a big one right there.
Nelson now on the low block trying to go over Allison Arns, and she does. Good recognition there from Nelson, understanding the 5'10 Arns is behind her on the low block. Just go up with it. You're going to have a good opportunity and a good shot, and she hit it.
Yeah, again, that growth, right? That patience and understanding to know where you're out on the floor and who's guarding you.
That's going to be a traveling call on Frederick. Pioneers have ratcheted up the defense here at the start of quarter number two, and they're making some hay here. They've got the ball back. They're down six. Claire Gritt is back in there. Nelson and Jeffcoat sub out. A lot of changes there for both teams. Grace White back in there. Courtney Smith is in there. And here's a change. Zone defense here in the half court from the Coyotes. Corn Gable, number two, back in there. Pressuring Gritt there. Now Smith with an opening. She's taking it right to the basket. Missed it. Rebound. Put back. And she got fouled.
Well, that was recognized first by Claire Gritt on the baseline, and Coach was calling the play. But DU did a great job. I mean, they set up a half-court trap. They broke it. They got a great look, and here we are at the free throw line. And you mentioned it. I mean, DU is shooting 70% from the floor. They're down six. They're not stopping anybody on the defensive end right now. They picked it up, but they're going to have to keep playing better. But, yeah, they fought their way right back into this one.
Smith gets her own rebound there and then fouled on the putback. She splits the pair, one of two. Her first miss of the season. She's now 7 of 8 from the free throw line on the year. McKeever going in deep. She got fouled by Romanowski, and McKeever there just able to draw the foul, really.
Yeah. And Romanowski is frustrated on that. She felt like she was going straight up, but McKeever did a great job of creating the contact on that one, as you see on the replay. So that's going to be an easy call for the referee.
First foul for Romanowski. She's having a discussion with one of the officials. Today's officials, Robert Strong, Teresa Wallach, Matt Schutt, making all the calls. McKeever connects on the first. Benz fires and nets the second as well. The junior, Merskine, Minnesota. Very good defender. Years past, she's been tops in the league, steals per game. Not quite there this season. Grit up top now to Romanowski. They got a mismatch there with Smith against McKeever, but Lovett's open for three, and that always works.
Well, and here's what I love about that play, Brad. Romanowski looked into Smith, drew the defender from the backside, and left Lauren Lovin wide open in the corner. Romanowski set that up from the beginning. Offensive foul, we're going the other way, and the momentum has certainly shifted.
Pioneers and this crowd here at Hamilton starting to get into it. Nelson leading the way with 11 points. She's on the bench right now. Lovin with 9, including 3 from the outside.
And here, Denver has a chance to cut this to a one-possession game.
I've got Lovin with 11
here. I do,
here.
Too.
We'll check on that.
I
she hit that first jumper from inside the arc.
Yep.
So.
And 3 threes.
I didn't mean to shorter that bucket there. Just looking at the stat monitor here as Grace White scores inside, and the Coyotes need a timeout. Dawn Pitzuwhite wants to talk things over on the Coyotes bench because the Pioneers have trimmed this lead to just 2.
Yeah, what a response from the Pioneers. We talked about it. They got down by double digits, and that's a dangerous place to be against a team like South Dakota who plays such great defense. But they've picked up the offense. They're shooting 70% from the floor. They're getting to the basket. They're playing team basketball. And the pace of play is exactly where Denver wants it.
And when you're a team that scores like they score at 83 points a game, you're not out of it. Certainly you don't want to get down. And they were down big to Western Illinois, which eventually was their undoing. But not 11-2 to start the game. Not terrible. And when they got this kind of firepower, they start going. Lovin's hitting from the outside. They're getting some transition buckets. It's really going together with the defense, and they've got very active hands defensively.
Yeah.
Coming up with a number of deflections, and that pressure has forced them into the Coyotes to do a number of traveling calls and turnovers. So it's going their way here in the second quarter.
Yep.
Let's see which pace, you know, who can dictate the pace and the style of play, because lately it has been the Pioneers, and when they shoot like this, I mean, every team's good that shoots 70%.
Well, we talked about this being a benchmark game. What we're seeing right now is they can compete with South Dakota. They can compete with the top teams in the Summit. Now the question is, can you compete for 4 quarters? Can you extend this out for the next 2 quarters and a half? It's hard to believe. We still got 4 minutes, 56 seconds left in the second quarter, and it's 39-41. I mean, but we'll see. We'll see as we go.
And certainly that's the way the Pioneers want to play. And South Dakota is not shooting bad. They're shooting 58%. The Pioneers shooting 70%. That's how you get a score like 41-39 with 4:50 to go. Pioneers are going to have the ball back. Long it inbounds in front of her own bench. Gets it to Romanowski. Coach Turgeon up off the bench. Calling out the offense here. White in traffic. That's going to be an offensive foul. Grace White forcing the issue there.
Well, and that was a play call specifically for that. They tried to get White the ball to drive the basket here. And just a great job of getting in position from Monica Arnes there. Again, tough defense. They know where to be. They help each other out.
Sort of what you expect with Coach Plitzu-White calling the timeout. You know she's going to talk defense.
Yep.
And right away, South Dakota in good position on that very next possession. White now is going to be called for traveling there. Duffy trailing the play surprised her a little bit coming from behind as White was anticipating, I'm open for three, maybe I'll drive it.
Yep.
Got caught in between.
Well, and that's just a hustle play there from a great athlete in Duffy. She knew she had to get back. She hustled back and forced the turnover.
Kira Duffy, great player, junior from Rapid City, South Dakota. Caitlin, her older sister, also playing for the Coyotes. And here in Colorado, Colorado State, before transferring to South Dakota. Caitlin often injured. Didn't quite have the career that she had hoped, but very good player in her own right. And so is her younger sister, Kira Duffy, here today. His first team All-Summit League a season ago, preseason All-Summit League as well. She's got it here against White. Couple of moves up and under and in.
Yeah, you're talking about her right there. She can score from the outside. She can score from the inside. Her and Arns are so versatile. That's what makes them so valuable to this team.
Well, she's listed as a guard.
Yeah.
But you saw that play there. That didn't look like guard play. That looked like a strong post player.
Yeah, and that's what South Dakota's known for. They have these players that can play inside and out. We talk about them playing four guards, but these aren't 5'5 guards. These are 6-foot guards that can play anywhere on the court. And then here on the other end, we saw Jeffcoat get a deflection defensively. She's at the free throw line again, having a great start to the game.
That one is up and in. 2 for 2 from the line. Jeffcoat from Monarch High School. 72% free throw shooter on the season. Simmental and Nelson head over to the scores table to check in as Jeffcoat connects again. 3 for 3 from the free throw line so far here in the first half. Lovin and White sub out with Simmental and Nelson back in there. The Arms sisters, Duffy, Lamb, and McKeever out there for South Dakota. And Duffy again showing off her versatility and scoring ability there.
And that's a tough matchup for Nelson. Nelson is athletic enough to guard, but just being on the outside, that's tough.
Nelson with a nice rebound, though, able to answer Duffy's basket with a bucket of her own.
Strengths for Nelson, rebounding and scoring down low. And strengths for Duffy, driving and using her athletic ability. We saw both back to back.
13 points in the contest for Nelson as Jeffcoat able to draw the foul. McKeever lowering the shoulder there.
Well, just a great job here. We'll see on the replay, you know, being in the right place, getting position, helping out. Jeffcoat has been all over the floor defensively. She's made an impact on both ends, and it's great to see her playing so well. She struggled early on in the season. She's really picked it up the last couple games.
Corn Gable, number 2, back in there for South Dakota, along with number 1, Claudia Kunzner. McKeever and Lamb went out. Romo's going to try the 3, and she connects. Second of the game for Sam Romanowski, the senior from Mount Lake Terrace, Washington.
And Denver takes the lead there. But what I love about that is Romanowski did not hesitate for a second about taking that shot.
Monica Arns with a quick 3 at the other end. Pioneers attacking. Romanowski to a cutting Nelson. It got deflected, but Jeffcoat has it in traffic, up and in.
Man, that's, you know, when things are going well, they're going well for everybody, and you love to see it. You love to see it.
Pioneers on top by 3, 48-45. Allison Arns says, we need a bucket. She gets it, and she got fouled, an opportunity for a 3-point play.
Yeah, and that's a tough one. Coach Turgeon's not wanting that to be on the shot. I was hoping for an on the floor foul there, but you mentioned it. You got Arns, you got Duffy. They're going to take over when they need to in this game.
Yeah, the senior recognizing the Pioneers were on a 7-0 run.
Yep.
And she gets a step on her defender, goes right to the rim. As you mentioned, possibly not a shooting foul, but the continuation there. So the bucket is good along with the free throw, and we are tied at 48 with 1:45 remaining here before halftime. Romanowski left wing calling for a high screen from Jeffcoat. Top of the key, hesitation move, up with it, won't go, but Jeffcoat's right there. Tough shot, may have gotten fouled, no call, and the rebound goes to South Dakota.
Jeffcoat just needed to calm down there and make a good move towards the basket.
Allison Arns gets away with something there, and now it's going to be traveling call, so it does work out for the Pioneers.
And Brad, I think that's what they call a makeup call in the business there. I think the ref recognized what happened.
What business? What are you speaking of?
Oh, nothing.
Pioneers will have it back. We're tied at 48. Claire Gritt back in there. Courtney Smith also back on the floor. So where's Lauren Levin in the far corner? Fake the handoff to her. Now she flares to the top. She's going to take it inside. Now Gritt in the near corner. Levin's got three threes already. This time it's the assist to Smith, and she can't convert the basket, but beautiful dish there from Lauren Levin.
The Pioneers are playing with a lot of confidence on the offensive end. They're making the smart play. Right here we see Levin with a drive, a nice dish. They're using the help defense from South Dakota against them. South Dakota's just over-helping a little bit. They're getting the driving lanes, giving Denver the opportunity to score some easier baskets.
Corn Gable subs out. McKeever back in there. Smith missed the first. This one comes off as well. The Pioneers had a chance to take the lead there, but they can't convert. Monica Arns, top of the key to her sister Allison on the left wing. Spinning in the lane. Shot fake. Missed. Rebound. Put back short. Smith fighting for the rebound, and eventually Nelson comes away with it for Denver. Long pass up ahead to Love, and she's behind the defense. That layup's up and in.
Nice
finish.
Job. Nice job by Denver there. Did give up the offensive rebound, but eventually got the ball. And Levin, always looking to score. She was out running.
That is how quickly they turn good defense into a basket. Explosive Denver offense. That one came up short. Rebound to Duffy. She's going to put it back up with a left hand, and that one rolls around and drops for Kira Duffy.
And that's here's the last basket of the game. Or of the half, excuse me.
If they don't score in the second half,
that'd be pretty nice.
I don't anticipate that. A high-scoring affair, 50 apiece here between South Dakota and Denver. An extremely entertaining first half. 20 minutes of basketball is in the books, and we're right where we started a tip-off. Yeah. Tied between these two teams who are shooting the ball extremely well. The Pioneers 67%, 20 of 30 from the field, and South Dakota 51.4%.
Yeah.
That's truly impressive. We got more basketball to come. We're going to take a break here during halftime. We'll be back before the start of the second half to go over some highlights and stats. The Coyotes and the Pioneers knotted at 50. It's halftime.
Thank you. Tomorrow, 60 degrees in Denver. We'll be warmer than it was today. Tomorrow will be the warmest day we've had in weeks.
Back here at halftime, Adam Gleason, Brad Thompson with you on the Pioneer All Access. A very entertaining first half, 50-50. We are tied, but it was South Dakota early on, jumped out to a big lead. Pioneers able to rally back. They eventually would take the lead, and then South Dakota able to tie things up right before the half. So a lot of offensive firepower that favors the Pioneers. I don't think Coach Plitzewite is used to teams putting up 50 points on them in 20 minutes of basketball.
They averaged giving up 55. So, no, not at all. And then you mentioned it. It was a game of runs in the first half both ways. The first quarter, South Dakota played a little bit better. Denver had the second quarter, shooting 73% in that quarter. A lot of good things going on.
Pioneers were led by Madison Nelson on the inside with 13 points. Lauren Lovin on the outside with 13 points. Lovin with three threes. Nelson had three of her own, five rebounds, two assists, two steals. Sam Romanowski, 8 points, seven assists in the first half. And, oh, by the way, she played all 20 minutes in the first half.
Yeah, she's the key for Denver. She's distributed the ball so well. She gets the ball to people where they want it to score. And then we also talked about this. You know, we talked about the depth of South Dakota versus, you know, the Pioneers having a little bit more of a lack of depth. Well, Pioneers have 15 bench points to South Dakota's 9 in the first half. So bench really stepping up, particularly Jasmine Jeffcoat.
Jeffcoat, 9 points in 12 minutes of action. She got a lot of time out there. Claire Grick got in a little foul trouble, so we didn't see her as much. But Jeffcoat out there right now in place of Courtney Smith starting the second half as teams are getting ready to kick things off here. Romanowski, Nelson, Jeffcoat, Lovin, and Grit out there for the Pioneers. On the flip side, leading the way for South Dakota, Allison Arns, 12 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists. Kara Duffy in double figures with 10 points. But the leading scorer, Chloe Lamb, she hit 3 3-pointers, 3 of 4 from beyond the arc. She had 13 points. So the Pioneers have got to keep an eye on where she's at. Duffy and Arns get so much attention, and all of a sudden Lamb is left open. There's two good passing guards. Traveling is going to be the call there on the inside. And you knew that was the right call because both officials, two out of the three officials, making the signal there. They're both on the same page.
Yeah, and Romanowski did a great job of surprising Duffy there as she cut, forcing the travel and the turnover.
Jeffcoat on the low block, turning, shooting, another travel, and call this down against the Pioneers.
Yep, and she did. She moved her feet. She was trying to post up. Great defense there by South Dakota, and she shuffled. So we start the second half with two travels.
Taylor Frederick there playing defense. She picked up two fouls in the first half. Didn't play a ton of minutes. So she was on the bench for a little bit. Duffy that time wanting a foul call. She did not get it. Romanowski out to Jeffcoat. Took her eye off of it. Able to keep it alive in front of the bench. Now inside to Nelson. Tough angle there to use the glass. A little too strong that time. But good work offensively. Good look inside to Nelson.
Yeah, great job there from Jeffcoat. And then here she is on the other end, forcing the tie-up. And the refs really allowing some contact. I mean, we mentioned it early on in some of the early games that they were calling things tight. Well, now as we get into conference play, they really start to allow the players to play a little bit more. And we see that here this evening with a lot of physicality from both sides on the defensive end.
Romanowski that time from the perimeter came down low, got a hand on it, and then allowed Jeffcoat to get her hands in there, delayed things just enough. So good team defense that time. Lovin could not connect. Duffy with a rebound. Now she's going to take it in transition. Kick out to Lamb. Shot fake. Now she's going to reverse. Good passing here from South Dakota. McKeever puts up a wild shot but banks it in. She was a little off balance after she got inside, but still athletic enough to put it up on the glass and put it in.
Yeah, great finish. Great finish. Tough shot.
Romanowski with a pull-up jumper off the mark. Allison Arns there for the rebound. Took it off the hop there. Now she's top of the key. Inside, lost her balance. Kicked out to Lamb, who's been hot from the outside. Not that time, though, as McKeever inside for the rebound. One of the shorter players on the court able to get on the offensive glass. And I'm so sure Coach Turgeon, that was a point of emphasis. And that's going to be an offensive foul along the baseline. Claire Grit, foul number 3.
Yeah, so a lot of things happened there, Brad. But right here, you see the foul she did. She lowered her shoulder. Just a great defensive position. They probably made it a point of emphasis to get her back on the bench early. But, you know, on the other end, Nelson's not going to let McKeever get two rebounds on her. That's what you saw after the second rebound there.
Nelson averaging 9.5 boards a game. Truly impressive as Shervin back in there, 34, able to draw the foul that time on Lovin. And that's certainly a mismatch.
Yeah.
Lovin, 5'7". Hannah Shervin, the redshirt sophomore, 6'2", and her wingspan is 6'5". Yeah. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, no. I mean, and she's shooting over 50%, you know, because of that. She has the size down low. And as we see here, Denver struggling offensively. I mean, they're not going to shoot 70% for the whole game. So the fact that they've missed a few shots isn't super surprising. The good news is they've only allowed 3 points here in the second half, so they're still hanging right where they need to be if they're going to struggle offensively.
Shervin, the transfer from New Mexico, did not play a lot in the first half due to foul trouble. So they've got to keep her off the glass. We mentioned that wingspan. She's got a big advantage on the inside. This is a hand check against McKeever here. But she's a dominant force on the inside. Over 9 points, almost 6 rebounds, leads the team in blocks and steals and field goal percentage. She had a double-double against Iowa State, one of the ranked opponents this South Dakota team has taken back. So has taken down, I should say. So against some of the best teams in the country, she's shown up. So didn't play a lot in the first. She's got the rebound here in the first half. But she's a player to watch out for. Cannot let her get going, perhaps get her in foul trouble as the Coyotes did to Grit here early in the second half. Malonga, far side, hits a screen, now kicks it to Lovin. She's going inside with it, up with the left hand, count the basket.
What a beautiful move there, left-handed, just a powerful move through the lane. Lovin is really feeling it tonight.
Lovin leads the Pioneers 15 a game. She's at her season average already. Plenty of time left in this one.
Well, and they've gotten Lovin the ball where she wants it, but she's also created her own shots. You know, she got out in transition for a layup. She's made a couple jumpers. And so she's really learning how to create a shot for herself because teams really stifle her knowing how potent she is from the three-point line.
Monica Arns off the mark there, 89% free throw shooter on the season. These Arns sisters really could shoot it from the free throw line. Allison at 92%, and I doubt Monica is going to miss this one after missing the first. That doesn't often happen.
Well, you talk about it. How many hours in the driveway were they shooting free throws together to get to that point?
Romanowski now getting inside, got a step on her defender, able to finish off the glass.
And she had and she's had such a great start to the game here already in the second half. She's 4 for 4. Well, 4 for 5.
On the verge of a double-double, 4 for 5, 10 points, 8 assists already for Samantha Romanowski. Shervin inside, trying to go through Jeffcoat there. Jeffcoat got a piece of that one. 55-54, Coyotes with the lead, Pioneers with the basketball. Jeffcoat inside, and the Pioneers have the lead back.
And there's an assist for Romanowski, but what you love there is the composure to grab the ball for Jeffcoat, stop where she is, and make the easy basket. Denver just really playing well.
Jeffcoat got sent to the floor there, the foul on Shervin. That's going to be her third personal.
Yeah, so key players out for each team. Grit on the bench with 3 fouls for Denver. Shervin on the bench with 3 fouls for South Dakota.
Shervin that time hoping for an and-one. And you go back to the previous possession, right? Jeffcoat had the advantage with the contact. Shervin ratchets it up a notch, a little bit more physical. And that time picking up the foul. Lovin from the outside. Count all three of those. The Pioneers lead 59-55.
Well, and a great job to get her open where she wants the ball. A nice high screen from Jeffcoat to get that opening.
Jeffcoat able to tie up Allison Arns.
And Jeffcoat is just putting her finger on every part of this game. She's playing well defensively. She's playing well offensively, setting screens, being physical. creating turnovers. I mean, she is having such a great game.
Jeffcoat getting a number of minutes. It's Courtney Smith. She's picked up a couple of fouls. She's on the bench right now, and Jeffcoat is in there as Allison Arnes along the baseline knocks that one down. Malonga right to the basket. Here's where she excels but couldn't finish there.
A great move, just has to finish that one.
Very tough to guard in transition or knifing to the basket. Very quick. Under 5 minutes to go here, third quarter. Frederick trying to post up Jeffcoat. Now Arnes top of the key going inside. This time her sister Monica and finishes with the left hand.
Yeah, and South Dakota is really trying to take advantage of Lovin on the block. Whoever she guards is going down to post up. So Denver's really going to have to keep an eye on that and help her out.
White with the three-pointer off the mark. Jeffcoat trying for the rebound. Instead, it's McKeever going the other way in transition. Probing, now retreating. Cross-court pass, Lovin steals it. Lovin, pull-up jumper, count it.
And that is such a deadly shot. I mean, you can't stop it. I mean, if you try to come up, she's going to blow by you for a layup. When you can hit that shot, that is just so, so deadly in transition.
20 points, a game high for Lauren Lovin. Pioneers have the lead back. Duffy from deep. Malonga there for the rebound.
And that's where we see a difference from the first half. She was giving up rebounds to Arnes. There she gets it herself.
Into the corner to White. Bullet pass across to Romanowski, who's been hot from the outside. That one deflected out. And it will be South Dakota basketball. I believe that was Jeffcoat over the top, trying to keep it alive, the last to touch it. We've got a timeout on the floor with 3:46 remaining here in the third quarter. 61-59 is the lead for the Pioneers over the Coyotes. We're going to step aside and we'll be right back. Thank you.
Yep.
Pioneers back out on the court. Grit coming off the bench here. She's been in foul trouble, three personals, but back out there. Pioneers with five players averaging double figure points. Claire Grit, one of them, 12.6 a game. That's the balanced scoring attack. You've got Nelson at 15 a game, Lovin at 15 a game. She's got 20 in this one. Mm-hmm. So the Pioneers really able to score the basketball and excel offensively. And right now they're doing it against one of the best defensive teams in the country.
Yeah, one of the best in the country, best in the summit. And the one area that the Pioneers need to improve on is rebounding. They're losing that battle by 10, and that's what's keeping South Dakota in this game, as well as shooting well from the free throw line.
Jeffcoat is playing out of her mind right now. A block at one end, an and-one opportunity at the other. My goodness.
Wow, and let's not forget, that is the 10th assist for Samantha Romanowski. Double-double here in the third quarter. 10 points, 10 assists. And you're absolutely right. Jeffcoat playing out of her mind. Grit has been on the bench, hasn't had a lot of scoring. Courtney Smith struggling to score the ball. And Jeffcoat's really picking up the slack there.
Jeffcoat has played in every game this season, so it's not like she's not in the rotation. She's out there every game as she connects on the three-point play, but averaging just 7.5 minutes a game.
Mm-hmm. Well, and the increased physicality that the refs are allowing is helping her, because that's her style of play. She wants to be physical and play, so they're allowing her to play her style of game. Typically, she gets in foul trouble, those kind of things shakes her confidence. She's being able to stay out there. Confidence is high, and here you go.
14 points in 18 minutes, 5 of 7 from the field, 4 of 4 from the free throw line, 3 rebounds and a block. This is going to be an offensive foul. Grace White is going to pick that one up. Legal screen.
And that's the right call, a tough one when Romanowski was coming off to be wide open, but probably the right call. Jumped a little late on the screen.
Coach Turgeon up off the bench, clapping, encouraging his Pioneers who have the lead. They're up 5 here. Arnes inside. Crowd wanted to travel. She's going to get 2 points.
And again, you see those guards and their ability to post up. That's just the strength of South Dakota.
And such good footwork. We've seen him a couple of times. What a catch there. A bullet pass from Romanowski in tight quarters, and Jeffcoat continues to score.
And Jeffcoat's like a whole new player, catching the ball out of, you know, tough passes, finishing with contact. It's just amazing to see.
White with the deflection. Grit going the other way, and that's going to be a foul on Duffy. 2 shots for Claire Grit.
Well, and even with 3 fouls, Claire Grit is going to go to the basket hard. She's not afraid to take the ball to the hoop, and Duffy doing what every player is taught, don't allow her to make the shot with the good, clean, but hard foul.
You could see the look on Claire Grit's face when she spun around there on the court saying, please, that cannot be. You cannot call that on me. And indeed, the call going against South Dakota. So she will be at the line. We've got a timeout on the floor. 2:15 remaining, 66-61. Pioneers with the lead. Yeah. And they continue to shoot the ball well. 61% from the field, 50% from beyond the arc, 7 of 14. Have gone to the free throw line a limited number of times, just 5 of 8 from the free throw line. But when you're shooting the ball this well, you're tough to beat.
Yeah, and you know, as you look at the stats for the Pioneers, the third quarter has historically been their best quarter this season. That's where they outscore opponents the most. But the fourth quarter is the only quarter where they get outscored. So as we go into the last 2 minutes here and into the fourth quarter, the good news is some of those starters are a lot more fresh than they typically are to enter in the fourth quarter. And you're having such tremendous play from Jeffcoat. There's a lot of upside. But with 12 minutes and 15 seconds to play, this is gut check time. Are you going to be able to beat a team like South Dakota? If you're going to, it's going to be tonight.
Looking at some other stats, comparing things, normally South Dakota averages 10 steals a game. They have 2. Pioneers with 8 team steals. And then assists-wise, Romanowski is just playing a superb game right now. As a team, the Pioneers have 17 assists. South Dakota with just 9. Yep. Pioneers are used to distributing the basketball, but so is South Dakota, and they just have 9 right now as a team.
Yeah, no, and 11 for Romanowski. She has more assists than South Dakota does as a team, and South Dakota plays team basketball. That's how impressive Romanowski has played tonight.
That one spun out as Grit looking for her 3rd point. She can get it from the line here. And last year at home against South Dakota, Claire Grit, 15-point performance. And she's the 2nd team All-Summit League preseason performer. And the newcomer team a year ago. As Duffy inside and Romanowski trying to come up with a steal, the reach in. Pioneers have been very active defensively, collapsing on.
Yep.
You've seen a number of those guards posting up, and you've seen Arnes, you've seen Duffy, and the defense of the Pioneers collapsing. They're trying to help out some of their smaller players getting posted up. I mean, Kira Duffy, 6'1", guard.
Yeah.
Posting up another, you know, Pioneer there. That's a tricky setup. So the double teams have been coming down, and it's been pretty effective, although this time Duffy is at the line. She connects.
Yeah, and Romanowski was right there. She just lifted up for a pass right when Romanowski went for the steal. It was a foul. But again, like you said, the defense has worked relatively well to slow down the scoring on the inside, so you can't complain too much.
Corn Gable back out there, number 2 for the Coyotes. Romanowski thought about the 3 from the left wing. Keeps her dribble alive, 12 seconds on the shot clock. Pick and roll there for Jeffcoat. Kick out to Grit for three. That one rimmed out. Monica Arns with a rebound.
Well, that was a great offense. That's the shot you want, and just a great job by Jeff Coat to find her. It just didn't fall.
Allison Arns thought about the three. Corn Gable with a shot fake from the outside. Now underneath, that one deflected. Allison Arns the last to touch it. Jeff Coat and Arns ending up on the deck there. It's going to be Pioneer basketball.
Yeah, and that could have easily been Claire Gritt's fourth foul. Lucky there, maybe, that the ref didn't call that one. But needless to say, Pioneers have the ball.
67-63 is the lead for the Pios. Nelson back in there, 23, as 22 puts it up and in. Sam Romanowski.
She's played an excellent game. 13 points, 11 assists. That's exactly what you want your point guard to do.
Nelson with the steal. Going the other way. Stops, puts it up with a left hand for two.
She might have got away with the travel there, shuffling her feet, but we'll take it. Up nine.
Nelson at her season average. She's got 15 to go along with nine rebounds. Allison Arns going to line up a three. That one too deep. Romanowski up high for the rebound. Out to Claire Grit now. Grit in front of her own bench on the right wing. Got a screen from Jeff Coat. Now Lovin's going to fire a three. It's good! The sharpshooter from Scottsdale, Arizona, has given the Pioneers a 12-point lead.
And she knew that was in right when she let go. She was going back court. She knew absolutely that was falling.
Lamb with a tough shot, and the Coyotes needed that. Lamb able to put that bucket in, get some momentum back for South Dakota before the quarter break. But DU with 25 points in the third quarter. They were tied at 50 at halftime, and Pioneers outscoring the Coyotes by 10 in the third quarter. My goodness, what a fourth quarter we have coming up. Stay with us, 75-65 Pioneers. Back to action here at Hamilton Gymnasium. Lauren Lovin right in front of the table in front of us on the far side of the court looking to inbound here to start things in the fourth quarter. 10 minutes of action remain. Evan Brad here with you as the Coyotes and the Pioneers match up in a high-scoring affair here in the Mile High City. Jeff Coat goes down there, that pass outside. Romanowski already with the double-double, 11 assists. What a performance she has had. Jeffco playing extremely well. Nelson doing what she's done all season, and it's going to be 3 second violation. Jeffco is limping now, and she's going to head out. Let's hope that's nothing serious, as Nelson got trapped in the corner.
Yeah, got trapped in the corner there. There was a 3 second violation. Denver, they can't play not to lose. They got to keep playing their game. Here up 10, and we'll see. They've had a lot of close games lately, so you hope their confidence isn't shaken from some of those losses.
Certainly got to stay aggressive. That's how they play. Shervin inside, and that's going to go against Smith. She's going to pick up the foul, and if they want to slow down the Pioneers, here's a good way to do it.
Yeah.
Go inside on the low block. They've been doing it all game, this time to a post player.
Yep.
And she's going to get to the line, try and slow down this Pioneers attack as Hannah Shervin connects on the burst.
Well, and both teams, obviously Jeffcoat out over getting stretched out, but back to full strength, if you will. They don't have people sitting out because of foul trouble. Shervin's back in. McKeever's back in for South Dakota. Grit, of course, back in for Denver. And so we have the full extent out there to finish this game.
Jeffcoat is getting some attention from the trainers. Does appear to be okay. Grace White came in for her number one. Skip pass there. Zone defense. I beg your pardon. It just appeared that way for a moment. Here's Nelson at the elbow. Love an open for three. You don't want to do that.
No.
Because it results in 3 points for the Pioneers.
Well, and that was a mistake there defensively to go help off. And Romanowski, I mean, she's on the top of her game. She knew exactly who was going to be open on that. And Lovin taking full advantage.
Lovin coming off a career-high 28. Three-second violation on Shervin there. And Lovin, 28 points career high against Western Illinois, the Pioneers last game. She is at 26 right now, 10 of 14 from the field, including 6 of 9 from beyond the arc. She's has some room here again. We'll see if they give it to her. White now goes down low to Nelson. That one rolls off the rim, but she's going to go to the line.
Great pass, great find by White, post-to-post passing there. Of course, White plays guard as well, so that helps her out. But, yeah, the Pioneers are playing so confident. They're staying calm in the midst of mixing defenses that look like a zone, maybe a man.
I was fooled.
You were fooled.
Could have been a matchup. Could have been a matchup.
I don't know. Of course, Nelson missed the free throw, the first free throw there, but Pioneers up by 12.
Second free throw, rattles around and drops in. Nelson with 16 points, 8 rebounds. Duffy. Now they go in the low block to Shervin. And a reach in from Nelson that time, and the bucket goes down. And one situation for Shervin. You can see her ability on the low block. She hasn't been out there due to foul trouble, but they could go to her, and it's a mismatch at 6'2" and a 6'5" wingspan.
And that's you're absolutely right, Brad. You talked about it. Just the fact that she had to sit out so many minutes was affecting their offense. She misses the opportunity for the three-point play, but yeah, she's very talented down on the block.
Romanowski trying to go on the low block to White. Back out to Romanowski. Jab step into the lane. Pull up jumper. That one came off a little flat.
Yep.
And here comes South Dakota in transition. Kira Duffy running the floor, finishing with a left hand. And Coach Turgeon wants a timeout as it's 79-70 here. The Pioneers want to get Jeffcoat back in there. She goes to the scores table and get the momentum back here.
Yeah. Well, and you know what? That was a great job by South Dakota to run the floor, get an easy basket, try to get the momentum shifting back their way. They were down by 13 about 30 seconds ago, now down 9. And so Coach Turgeon wisely taking a timeout, slow the momentum, try to set up an offense to get a basket down here, get Jeffcoat back in, who's had just a career day. And I think you just got to keep running the offense through Romanowski. I mean, she has 12 assists, 13 points, making excellent decisions. This is it. This is what we talked about. What, you know, this is your test. Can you compete at the highest level of the Summit League? Can you win a game? And here you have an opportunity. You're up 9. You got 7:43 left. Can you hold your composure? You know South Dakota's going to make a run. They were undefeated in the Summit League last year. And they're
going to be composed.
Yeah,
so
they're going to be composed.
There's no panic in them. They're down 9.
Not.
They've been here before. They played the best teams in the country this year and beat a number of them. So, yeah, certainly they're going to make a run. Pioneers are at home. That's the key. You could see the shooting difference, how good it is to be at home. You made the point very early on. Pioneers shooting the lights out right now at 62%. From the field overall, 10 of 18 from beyond the arc. My goodness, what a performance. But they got to pull it out with 7:43 left. There's a lot of basketball left to be played here. And Shervin has started to get it going on the low block. Here's some full court pressure now from the Pioneers. Romanowski going to be double teamed. Pass across to Claire Grit as they break the pressure. Well done by the senior Romanowski and her backcourt counterpart, the sophomore Claire Grit. Grit looking inside to Jeffcoat, going against Shervin, trying to pick up that fourth personal foul, and she did just that.
Yeah, that was such a great job, and that was drawn up that way. They were looking inside the whole time down here. They were trying to get that fourth foul on Shervin. Coach Turgeon recognized it just like you did. She was getting it going, which only opens up the floor for Arnes and Duffy. So getting that fourth foul is huge. Now Shervin's going to have to be really careful with 7:20 left in this game.
And it looks like she's going to stay in there as Jeffcoat connects on the first. Her career high is 17. Right now she's at 16. She can tie it here. And she does. Tying a career high. Jasmine Jeffcoat, the sophomore from up the road in Louisville, Colorado, just outside of Boulder, gives the Pioneers an 81-70 lead. Three seconds, Allison Arnes looked down, couldn't quite believe that call. That you rarely see a three-second call against a guard.
Yeah, well, and you see South Dakota going to their strength. They're trying to get the ball inside, whether it be to Shervin or the guard with a mismatch, but they're spending too much time posting up and not getting the ball in there quick enough.
Romanowski able to beat the pressure here. Little man-to-man pressure. Now Nelson to the top of the key, hand off to Lovin. Pressure extending here from South Dakota. Malonga step back jumper is two.
And that's a big, big shot there. That was a great defensive possession from South Dakota. You see them, they're talking, they're playing, playing together, and Malonga just hit a tough shot.
McKeever looking for an opening inside, kick out to Allison Arnes. Step back jumper, and she connects.
And you have to imagine they're going to be going to Arnes and Duffy almost every time down here, trying to get back into this game, down 11.
Arnes with a team high 18, Lamb with 15, Duffy with 14, the three players in double figures. Malonga goes down there. We've got a timeout from the Pioneers bench as the Pioneers were running out of room along the far sideline there. A couple of deflections, active hands from South Dakota, and Coach Turgeon alertly there says, let's get a timeout. Let's keep possession here. So critical, 6:05 to go. Well, the Pioneers have the 11-point lead.
Well, and Coach Pitts-White is frustrated. She wanted to travel there. Now, we could see that the ball was still bouncing from our vantage point. She could not, so it looked like a travel for her. But you can feel the tension from South Dakota rising with each possession as they see the 11-point lead. There's still plenty of time. We've talked about that. They're going to stay composed, but you can feel just the pressure to make baskets and make stops rising as we go.
Especially defensively, the ball pressure.
Yeah.
They are really challenging the Pioneers, extending things. We saw some full court there. They're extending out, switching screens. Now it looks like they're dropping back into a zone defensively. Malonga in traffic. That's going to be an offensive foul.
Yeah, and the second charge that Monica Arnes has drawn, she's playing down in the middle of the lane there, always in the right spot with the help. And, again, she was set for a long time, and Malonga just couldn't get around her.
Duffy kick out to Allison Arnes. Baseline three on the way, short. Fight for the rebound. Arnes came up with it, and then she's going to get fouled. The effort level and how hard the work rate, how hard she plays.
Yeah.
She's shooting a three-pointer, and all of a sudden she's underneath the basket.
Well, and she is not going to let them lose if she has anything to do about that. And Duffy's the same way. Their team has, you talked about the ball pressure, but their defensive talking, the ball pressure on the offensive end, the sense of urgency, offensive rebounding, they have picked it up a notch. And you see why they're so good because they're fighting their way back into this game.
Grit back in there. Malonga is out. Allison Arnes 92% from the line, as you might imagine, connects on both. She's got 20 points. That's 1,157 in her career as Duffy comes up with a block.
And kind of an ill-advised shot from Jeffcoat there. That's not where they want her shooting the ball.
Monica Arnes from the outside. She hits a big, big three, and all of a sudden it's 83-77, and the Pioneers are going to get another timeout as things are tightening up here with 5:18 to go.
Yeah, and 7-0 run and a minute and four here for South Dakota to cut this lead to six. And you kind of feel, even sitting over here, you feel Denver kind of getting tense, trying to make a good shot. The defense has picked up, you know, and it's getting tight here with 5 minutes left. So Coach Turgeon, I'm sure, trying to calm his team down, tell them to play their game, get the shot they want to take, and be confident.
And that confidence in getting back to being aggressive. You can see, it's the night and day when you see the Pioneers getting up and down the floor, making shots, their nonverbals, how they're communicating with their teammates and having so much fun out there. And now they're feeling a little bit. But this is part of the growth process,
yes,
right? You've got the lead at home against the top team in the league. And how do you handle it? How do you handle their run, their pressure? And that's going to be a foul against South Dakota. Duffy, I believe, is going to be the guilty party.
No, that's a great point, Brad. You know, this is growth right here. How do you handle, you know, having some prosperity here against a really good team and try to close it out?
Nelson outside, now into the lane. Underneath to Smith, beautiful pass. The cutting Courtney Smith underneath for two.
There's the Courtney Smith that we know. And Nelson with a great find, the post-to-post passing.
Monica Arns hit that last three before the timeout. Thought about it there. Lamb, we haven't heard much from her here in the second half as McKeever with a shot fake down the lane, up with a right hand, and drops that one in.
Yeah, good pump fake there to get a driving lane to the basket. Pretty solid defensive possession there right till the end for Denver.
Lovin in front of Coach Turgeon. Now up top, Romanowski. Shot clock is at 10. High screen coming from Nelson. Romanowski goes away from it underneath to Smith. We're trying to get a scoop layup shot. Monica Arnes going to pick up the foul. Smith will gladly head to the free throw line there as she kind of got caught in between going up on the front side and then reversing it.
Yeah. Well, and I think she probably should have taken the little jumper there. That's her shot. Hasn't had the best of nights, so she was trying to get a little better look there.
That one goes down.
And again, Romanowski just dicing apart that defense, making the right pass, getting the ball in her teammates' hands right where they need it to get two big points.
Smith hits those two. She's 3 of 6 from the free throw line. She subs out. White is now in there, number one. Duffy thought about the three. Now to Monica Arnes at the top. Now to her sister Allison. Down low to Lamb, who's got position.
Yeah, and right there, she should have gone up. I mean, she was open on the initial cut. I think she was surprised that she was as open as she was, and then gets the 3 second call down in the lane.
You're absolutely right. She had the shot initially. That's a quick 3 seconds.
Yeah,
I'll tell you what, she started to dribble it out of there.
Yep. And the South Dakota staff is very frustrated over there with those calls. That's the third 3 second violation they've had.
White to Lovin, a little bit too deep. Now back to White. Wraparound pass to Nelson. It's not going to count. White is going to pick up an offensive foul, player control foul there against Monica Arnes. She's done that a number of times.
Third one from Monica Arnes, and that is a huge, huge play for Monica Arnes because that was a beautiful pass. Beautiful pass and would have put Denver up by 10. It was the right call. I mean, Arnes has been in the right position so many times tonight. Monica Arnes, to say that. But, yeah, a huge, huge play defensively.
87-79. Duffy in the corner in front of her own bench. Crossover now along the baseline. Up and under, move and count that basket.
That is a tough, tough finish. I mean, she pump faked, got all the way under with her length to make the reverse layup. And you just see the competitive nature of Duffy and Arnes here as they just do not want to lose this game.
South Dakota with a deflection. They have it back. McKeever hesitated. Now she's going to fire from the outside. That basket's worth three, and all of a sudden it's 87-84.
Yeah, and that's how quickly it can change. South Dakota so good. And
Claire Gritt with the answer.
You love that. Claire Gritt, she makes big baskets in big moments.
Romanowski, 13 assists. Are you kidding me? Lamb now underneath, kick out to McKeever, open for another three. Too strong, fight for the rebound. Monica Arns over the back there as Jeffcoat had the position.
Yeah, Jeffcoat, great position there. Great hustle by Nelson to get a contest on that shot. She made a great job of help defense there to force McKeever to shoot that one long after making the last one. But 13 assists for Sam Romanowski.
Ties a career high, so she has a chance to set a new career high with the next sweet delivery. We'll see if that happens. Meanwhile, Jeffcoat at the line. That one rattles out. Shervin coming back in. Monica Arns subs out. And they've really been applying this pressure with five guards out there on the floor for South Dakota. They go back to a post player, but just one. Still four guards out there. Shervin back in with those four fouls. Jeffcoat makes the second. Duffy has been effective posting up. Now they go to Shervin. A little chicken wing action there to create some space. Now they go back inside on the roll. Kick out. Lamb open for three. Barely draws iron, but McKeever there for the rebound. Jeffcoat out of nowhere for the block.
Wow. Wow. What a block by Jeffcoat. McKeever wants a foul. She's frustrated. The South Dakota bench all pleading for it. Not going to get it, but just a great job by Jeffcoat here to come across with the help and just a beautiful block. She probably got a little bit of arm there, but
Arns underneath. They're going to get the call here, but that one came off the rim. Almost a three-point play. Allison Arns, that's that smart, experienced player.
Yes.
As soon as the ref hands the ball, you make that quick cut right underneath on the back door, and South Dakota was ready to deliver the pass. Arns there connecting from the free throw line.
Well, and that is something they've excelled at this evening really well. Their set plays on the baseline, they've gotten a lot of good looks, and if they don't make it, they usually get fouled. Denver struggled to guard the baseline out of bounds.
White is coming back in. Jeffcoat, this is more of an offense-defense substitution perhaps here. With 2:08 to go, 5-point lead for the Pioneers. Arns with 22 points, 8 of 14 from the field, 5 of 5 from the free throw line, 8 rebounds, 4 assists. Filling up the stat sheet, Shervin with a deflection. Diving on the floor to come up with it. Got it and a timeout. So the Pioneers with a turnover there in South Dakota. It's just what they needed with under 2 minutes to go. They get the ball back.
This is probably the biggest defensive possession of the game thus far coming up for the Pioneers. Now, both teams have one timeout left, but if South Dakota scores here, it's a one possession game. The pressure only continues to rise. So I'm sure Coach Turgeon is drawing up a nice defense, saying, hey, we're up. We got a we've got a 5-point lead here. Minute 57, this is where we want to be. This is exactly where we want to be. If you would have asked Coach Turgeon before the game, if he could have this scenario, he would take it 100% of the time.
Indeed he would. When you look at defending South Dakota, you've got Duffy, who's done most of her damage on the inside, quite frankly. Allison Arns can score from anywhere.
Yep.
She's been getting a ton of offensive rebounds, scoring inside, outside. And then Shervin is out there. They've gone to her on the low block as well. So we'll see what Coach Put Zoo White goes with here. Shervin is in the corner now, not underneath. Lamb has it inside. She's double teamed. Shervin cuts to the rim. Had a block from behind.
Yeah, great job by Jeffcoat to recover after she helped.
Lovin catch, fires the three. Went over the backboard. So it's going to be South Dakota basketball. Shervin went down hard there. She's slow to get up. Does appear to be okay as she heads to the other end.
Well, and that's a tough situation there. You know, Lovin, anytime she gets an open look at the basket, you want her to take the shot. Might have been a little quick in this situation, but it could have easily gone in.
And that's one of those ones where she didn't quite catch it clean. You know, it wasn't in the pocket. It wasn't where most shooters want it to go up with it. But again, she can fill it up. She's got 26. So,
and then unfortunately on this end, Lovin fouls, which is exactly what you don't want to do here. Stopping the clock, which is your friend, and allowing a very good free throw shooter to go to the line.
Lamb, 86%, puts that one in. This is a tremendous free throw shooting team.
Yep.
78% as a team, tops in the Summit League, 14th in the NCAA. Last year they led all of the country as a team in free throw percentage, so they're going to make them when they get to the line.
Well, and here you want to stay calm, run your offense, get a good look at the basket, and don't try to waste too much time. Just take what you get.
Romanowski with an open look. What a big shot. She drilled it.
And that's exactly what we're talking about. That's the shot you want to take. Right in your offense, comfort zone. Romanowski hits a big one.
Lamb underneath. Nice catch and move, but she couldn't finish. Now Duffy driving in, spinning back. Gets it to Shervin. McKeever driving in. Headed stripped by Romanowski. And it's just going to call a blocking foul there. It looked like it was clean, the hand stripping the ball away there, but on the body is the call.
Yeah, that's a tough call, a 50-50 call. You know, our perspective, it looked clean. The ref was on the backside, seemed like she hit with the body there, and McKeever at the line.
88% free throw shooter connects. Monica Arns back in there, that five guard lineup. And well, we saw it at the other end. If you move the ball enough, as they're pressuring and trying to trap there, you're going to get an open look. And Romanowski knocked it down last time. Now some full court pressure here. Romanowski stuck in the corner, and she gets knocked down. Allison Arns is going to be whistled for the foul, and Romanowski will gladly head to the other end.
Well, and that's experience of Romanowski to understand that nobody was getting open, so she kind of forced the contact there, drew a foul. We see her hit the big three on this end. She's had a career night, 13 assists. She's got 16 points. Chance to add to that right now.
First one up and in. Under a minute to play, Romanowski with four clutch points right now, can make it five after the three-pointer and misses that one. It's fight for the rebound. She's got it back. Pioneers can hold here and run some clock. Lovin, and she got fouled from behind. And the best three-point shooter perhaps in the country right now heading the free throw line for the Pioneers.
Well, and Coach Turgeon was doing jumping jacks over there telling his team to slow it down and to eat clock. And, again, it results in a foul here.
Lovin wastes no time connecting on that free throw.
And if you're going to miss, you want to miss like that for Romanowski on the last time getting the offensive rebound.
Lovin connects again. 97-90 right now. Pioneers do not want to foul and give up a bucket, but Chloe Lamb able to do just that. She scored and will go to the line.
Yeah, that's tough. Lovin tried to get out of the way on that one. Referee called the foul with the body. Let's see what happens here. You know, there was a little bit of elbow push. Lamb kind of forcing that contact. Romanowski did it on the other end too. They're calling it both ways. But yeah, you don't want to do that, giving up a three-point play.
Lamb puts that one up and in. She has 20 points in the contest. It's a four-point lead, a two-possession game right now with 41.5 to go. Full court pressure here from South Dakota. Grit to inbound. It looks like they're doubling Romanowski. They still get it to her. Up to Nelson, able to beat the pressure. Now to Jeffcoat. Goes in, misses, but she got fouled. And Monica Arns went down hard there. Looks like she's back up and okay. She's going to pick up the foul.
Well, and great composure there, right? Romanowski makes a good pass to Nelson. Nelson makes a good pass to Jeffcoat, and she doesn't travel as she takes the jump stop.
Two free throws here for Jeffcoat. First one, nothing but net. 8 of 9 from Jeffcoat from the free throw line in this one. 20 points on the evening, new career high for Jeffcoat. Also 4 rebounds. Second one comes up short. Duffy there for the rebound. 30 seconds remaining. Yeah. Allison Arns from the top of the key. Open look there. That one came off. Lovin with the rebound. And She got fouled there along the baseline. That's who the Pioneers want to go to the line.
Man. Yeah, and then similarly, South Dakota, that is exactly the shot they wanted. Allison Arns, top of the key, wide open. If they could ask for anyone to have that shot, they would have picked her. It just didn't fall that time, and Levin with the rebound.
Arns came in 49% three-point shooter on the season, one of five in this one. Levin wastes no time. I love it at the free throw line. Gets the ball in her hands, and next thing you know, it's splashing through.
Yeah, well, she's learned it, right? She has to get her shot off quick, and so you might as well get the free throw off quick.
99-93 is the count right now. 24.6 remaining. Pioneers trying to hit the century mark, and Lauren Levin does just that. 30 in the contest for Lauren Levin. My goodness. Pioneers don't foul. That shot is blocked by Grit. Now a scramble for it along the baseline. Last touched by Levin. So South Dakota will have it back, but just 15.7 to go. It is a three-possession game right now.
Yeah.
So do not foul.
Don't foul. We've seen them foul a couple times now.
And Coach Plitzewicz is going to take a timeout here for South Dakota. Oh, I beg your pardon. They're going over to the monitor to see who touched this last. So the officials taking this timeout. It gives South Dakota a chance to draw up a play, but they might not have the ball.
Who knows? We'll see here, but you know that Coach Turgeon on this end is emphasizing don't foul, play good defense, but don't foul, and then make sure that you get the ball in bounds. Looks like it might be off on South Dakota there. That's a tough one. I think it may have touched Lamb's hand last. Levin thinks so, and the replay as she's pleading for the ball there. But
to recap this series for a minute, Adam, 11-2 South Dakota has dominated this series. The Pioneers won the first ever matchup in 1988 and the first ever Summit League matchup, which was over in Magnus Arena. I was on the call for that one. That was in 2014. So since then, it has been all South Dakota. 11-2 is the series advantage for the Coyotes, but the Pioneers with a chance. So we leg, does it touch her foot?
It
appears
does.
That it does touch the outside of her foot, sending it across that end line.
Yeah, Coach Turgeon is out there mimicking what's happening on the screen. He's pointing to his foot to the referees. They're going to make the right call. They're over there checking it and double-checking it. But, you know, Brad, we talked about it. This was an opportunity for Denver. They're at home. They love to be at home. Struggled lately, but they're ready to get back on the right track. And they scored 100 points so far on a team that allows 55 points a game, who's played some of the best teams in the country.
Yeah, they have some signature wins over Iowa State and Missouri. And they didn't see it how we saw it. I got to give a shout-out to our crew here at Pioneer All Access. Great look there on that one. South Dakota will have the ball. However, Lamb open for three. She connects. What an evening she has had. Pioneers quickly get into Romanowski. She's under a lot of pressure there. Now to Levin, and she got fouled, so she will go to the line.
Well, like you said, I think that should have been the other way. It seemed pretty clear to me, but it results in 3 points for South Dakota. They ran kind of a wheel play where they kept running people around, and the defender got lost, giving Lamb the wide-open three, but here we are, Lovin back at the line, exactly who you want to be taking these free throws.
Lovin now, or Lamb, I should say, has a team-high 23 points. Two players over 20 points, Allison Arns and Chloe Lamb, but it may not be enough. 8.3 to go. Lovin hits that free throw. The second one up and in, 102 points to 96 for South Dakota, the Pioneers. On the verge. Now it's a two-possession game.
Yep.
So
yep.
They hit a three the last time. We don't want to get ahead of ourselves here.
Yes.
Pioneers, good position. You mentioned it. Don't foul. Make them use as much clock as they can without fouling.
Well, and they get to move the ball forward. Women's basketball, college basketball, you can advance the ball if you take a timeout. That was South Dakota's last timeout. So they're not going to be able to take a timeout if they do make a basket to set up a defense. So Coach Turgeon, I'm sure, is saying, hey, if they do make a shot, make sure we get it out quick, get the ball in, get the foul called. And this is an interesting point. What do you do here? Some coaches will try to go for the quick two, get the quick basket, and maybe get a steal or a foul. But down 6 with 8 seconds, I have to imagine they're probably drawing up a play for a three.
You'd imagine it's got to be a three-pointer. There's only 8 seconds left. Coach Turgeon kneeling there, talking to his team, associate head coach Kayla Ard, doing a lot of talking over there. She's tremendous. They have a great staff on this program. They handle these situations. You work on scenarios like this all the time in practice. So they've gone over this before. We'll see how they handle it. Romanowski, other than being incredible with 13 assists, has done a great job against this pressure here late. Now this lob toward the basket, kick out to Duffy, step back three, and that one goes down with 3.8 to go, and Nelson gets fouled there. So with a three-point lead, she's going to get two free throws. The key here to make at least one and make it a two-possession game.
Yeah, so, I mean, a great play call by South Dakota. It did eat up probably more time than they would have liked, but the lob was really a diversion for the three-pointer for Duffy, and Duffy made a really, really tough shot. Step back three from deep.
Nelson buries a pressure free throw. Wow, what a shot there from Madison Nelson, calmly stepping to the line with 2.9 remaining. She's going to make the pair, and South Dakota up against it right now. Two-possession game and not enough time left. Arnes trying to bank one in. The Pioneers win it 104-99. Their best win of the season, perhaps. The best win for Coach Turgeon in his career here at DU in his second season. They take down South Dakota, who came in 13-2 on the season, and they were undefeated in Summit League play. This is their first Summit League loss since 2017. Well done, Denver Pioneers.
Yeah, what a win. That's a signature win for Denver. We talked about it being such a big opportunity for them, a big growth point. You saw them push the lead up, things got tight, they responded. What a great performance here at home. 104 points on the Summit League and one of the best defensive teams in the nation.
Pioneers struggling coming into this one.
Yep.
Had one win in a number of games. They're on the road for 7 of the last 8.
Yep.
And to put up a statement win like this and doing it in this fashion, truly remarkable for the Pioneers. They were led by Lauren Lovin, 32 points. Sam Romanowski, 17 points, 13 assists. Nelson, 18 points to go along with 9 rebounds. Jasmine Jeffcoat, 20 points, a new career high, also 4 rebounds. A remarkable performance up and down the lineup when you look at this for the Pioneers, and they came away with a signature win.
Yeah, absolutely. People stepping up, playing minutes. They're not used to playing. Jeffcoat having a great night. I mean, people having career nights. Lovin, Romanowski, Jeffcoat, Nelson doing what she's done all season, 18 points and 9 boards. And things are looking up for Denver. Hopefully they can take this momentum into their game on Saturday.
It's going to be on Saturday.
Saturday. Sorry about that.
No problem. No problem. Pioneer shot 63% as a team, including 12 of 21 from beyond the arc. An outstanding performance. Biggest win of the season for the Pioneers. Let's hope they carry this momentum into the remaining Summit League action, specifically this weekend. Pioneers 9-7 on the season, 7-1 here at home, 2-1 at league play. North Dakota is the opponent, 7 p.m. Saturday night. Please join us for that on Pioneer All Access. From Adam Gleason, Brad Thompson, everybody here behind the scenes, the Pioneers win a huge one here, 104-99 over South Dakota. Thanks for joining us, and have a good night.